Well, President Hollande has declared a national day of mourning across France tomorrow. He said that the raid was an attack on the freedom of expression enjoyed in France. And no publication exploited the freedom like Charlie Hebdo, launching satirical barbs at all religions and none. But it was its repeated lampooning of Islam that triggered today's bloodbath. This declaration of solidarity, Je suis Charlie, has now been shared hundreds of thousands of times on social media. Our chief correspondent, Alex Thompson, looks now at the struggle between Western freedoms and Islamist diktat.
Charlie Hebdo, Charlie Weekly, is about controversy. One of a tiny handful of media organizations on the planet not afraid to satirize Islam, including publishing images of Muhammad, expressly forbidden by Islam. Firebombed in 2011 after its Sharia edition listed Muhammad as editor-in-chief. An earlier magazine had Muhammad on the cover in tears, wailing, "It's hard to be loved by jerks." It is Channel 4 News policy not to show these cartoons.
It's a left-wing, secular, very ballsy, anti-racist magazine. It lambasts all religions, all ideas, all minorities and majorities. It's a typically sort of robust French publication in a way.
There is wider friction, of course, between the French state and Islam. As of April the 11th, 2011, it's illegal to wear a face covering veil in public in France. Tomorrow, after weeks of controversy, a novel called Submission, imagining France as an Islamic state, is due to be published. Overseas, France's relationship with Islam, like ours, isn't just difficult, it's sometimes violent. Paris taking on Islamic militants in northern Mali a year ago, her forces are still there. And French forces, of course, involved in Afghanistan since way, way back in 2001. Today's events in Paris come at a particularly sensitive time next door in Germany. Cologne Cathedral plunged into darkness this week in protest against the rash of anti-Islamic demonstrations across Germany, which have been happening for some weeks now. But what can Europe's leaders do on the day of an event like this, beyond express revulsion, as Angela Merkel duly did visiting London? What's happened was a barbaric attack, she said, against all the values we hold dear, like democracy and freedom of expression. The weekly Commons pantomime of question time momentarily stilled, barely a couple of hours after the attack had happened.
I know that this House and this country stands united with the French people in our opposition to all forms of terrorism, and we stand squarely for free speech and democracy.
By coincidence, the Pope met French Muslim leaders at the Vatican today. The Catholic Church has long been an endless target for Charlie Hebdo cartoons, but today it also condemned this as an attack on free speech.
It's a double act of violence. Abominable because it's both an attack against people as well as against freedom of the press.
So religious and political leaders unite to condemn an attack on free expression. But are the attackers winning? Satire isn't dangerous unless you satirize Islam.
Terrorism works. It really works. It's what nobody realizes, but we've got to face up to it. Terrorism works because if somebody goes to an office and kills a whole load of journalists, as has happened today, other journalists will take the lesson. You know, the journalistic trade is filled with award ceremonies, people pat each other on the back for their alleged bravery and so on. What Charlie Hebdo has been doing in recent years really is brave, really is brave. And, you know, it works. It works terrifying people. After 2005, after the Danish cartoons crisis, the threats were made, everyone saw what happened, nobody republished the Danish cartoons.
In 1989, Iran's leader called for Salman Rushdie to be killed after he published the satanic verses. The Dutch filmmaker Theo van Gogh was murdered in Amsterdam after making a film about Islam called Submission. A year later, 50 people were killed in rioting worldwide after a Danish magazine published cartoons of Muhammad. And in 2010, the Swedish artist Lars Vilks was attacked whilst giving a lecture after he produced cartoons of the Prophet. So much for these few. For most, it seems, Islam has simply become off-limits for satire.
In the wake of the Danish cartoons affair, basically every other paper and magazine in Europe said, you know, we must stand in solidarity and so on, freedom of speech, but they obviously didn't really mean it because nobody else published. Charlie Hebdo was and has been really unique in a way because it realised that in a secular society, you cannot have one set of beliefs that is protected from criticism.
So have we all simply traded freedom of expression for personal safety? Have the Islamic gunmen, to that extent, won?
Alex Thompson reporting that.